Welcome back everyone. So we have completed Kipath land, so we'll continue from here. Today we are going to study the new topic in geographical feature of Nepal. So the types of soil available in Nepal. So the first one is alluvial soil. Alluvial soil is found in the Tarai region and in Vaisin, formed with a mixture of the soil deposited by the river and decomposes leaves. The soil has equal proportion of a sand and hard soil. This type of the soil contains the mixture of minerals like lime, phosphorus and potassium etc. Thus this type of soil is regarded as the most suitable for the agriculture. Paddy, jute, sugarcane, tobacco, pulses, lentils etc. grown luxuriously in this type of soil. So the second one is sandy pebbly soil, baluat pathrilo mato. This type of the soil is found in the Bhawa region, Inner Madhes and Churia Hills. This soil is made up of land piled up by the rivers, pebbles, loose and rough rocky materials. This type of the soils, which has low proportions of fertile soils and low organic matters, the water does not retain in this type of the soil, and the fertility of these soils is also very low. Irrigation in the land with this type of soil is very difficult, since economically important trees like teak, sisal flourishes in this type of the soil. Most important land of this type of the soil is covered in the forest. Third one is red gray soil, the soil that is formed in the mixture of decomposed wheat in the broken rock of steep cliffs of Mahabharata is called red clay soil. The soil of this region is red, gray or yellow because of the soil contains low amount of the organic matter and ionized iron. The minerals like lime, nitrogen, phosphorus and the layers of the soils are low. Paddy, sugarcane, jute, tobacco are not cultivated in this type of soil, but the soil contains the minerals like acid, iron etc. and thus it is suitable for the cultivation of fruit, tea, potato, maize and millet. So now we will Palaeolithic soil. The soil formed due to the drying of out of the lakes of the valley is called clay soil. This type of the soil contains lot of decomposed weeds, so the color of the soil is black. Since the layer of the soil is thick and the soil contains a lot of organic matters, the clay soil is best for agriculture. Paddy, wheat, vegetable in a particularly grow well in this type of the soil. Cultivation in this type of the soil can be done even in the less rainwater. This type of the soil is found in the Kathmandu Valley. So the third one is Himalayan soil. Himalayan soil is formed with the mixture of soil, sand, pebbles, conglomerates and rock deposited by the glaciers. This type of soil is mainly found at the foot of the inner and high Himalayan region. The climate is cold, dry and the layer of the soil is thin and there is less organic matters in this type of the soil, so the fertility of this soil is very low. Only the crops like maize, barley, potato, finger millets are grown in this type of the soil. So now we'll move to the next topic, that is forest. So the landscape, climate, soil etc. affected the vegetation of the particular place. Since the climate affects the vegetation, there is an interdependent relationship between the two. The forest resources have an important role in conserving and balancing the environment. However, there have been a widespread decline in the forest resources in the past few decades. According to the statistics, in 1954 AD, more than 45% of the land was covered with the forest, but around 1979 AD, it was 43% only. It was 37.5 4% in 1986 and survey carried out in 1998 AD showed that the coverage of the forest area was 39.6, whereas in survey 2014 AD revealed that forest area was reached to 44.74%. During the past decade, the forest in the many places were cleared for the settlement and resettlement. In some places, the forest was encroached. The vegetation of the Nepal was divided into five groups on the basis of the land diversified landscape and forest. The realm of the forest in the Nepal can be categorized into five groups on the basis of the landscape and diversity of the forest. The first one is subtropical evergreen forest, found at the altitude of 12,000 meters in the Tarai, Bhawar, Dun and Churia Hill. The trees in the subtropical region forest are taller, larger, stronger and evergreen since there are plenty of rainfalls and it's hot there. Running parallel from east to west and extending over the area of four coasts, that is 8 miles in the past, the forest are known as Charkosi Jagdi. Along with the main vegetation like teak, sisal, black cotch, silk curtain trees, sanvi, tadi, ganja are also found here. Since the wildlife like elephant, rhinoceros, tiger, bear, deer are found here, the forests are considered very important for the economical and biological point of the view. So the second one is temperate deciduous forest, found at the altitude of 1200 meters to 2100 meters in the upper and the central part of the Churi Hills and in the lower part of the Mahabharata Hills. The trees in this temperate deciduous forest are tall and big. Although the lower part is densely shaded, the upper part is cool and there occurs the frost causing a falling of the leaves and thus the forest is called deciduous forest. In the higher place, the mixture of the forest containing deciduous and coniferous trees are found in some extent. Among the evergreen deciduous and coniferous trees of hard and soft types are found here. Teak, pine trees, Himalayan cedar, golden milicia, chestnut, walnut, rhododendron, bodhi tree, needlewood, banyan, silk curtain tree, alder, bastard teak are the major one. These type of the forest are taken as the lower quality than the subtropical evergreen forest. So fourth one is coniferous trees. The coniferous forests are found in the upper part of the Mahabharata Hills and the lower part of the Himalayan mountain at the altitude of 2101 to 3315 meters. Since it is a cold and there is a snowfall throughout the year, the shape of trees and their leaves are pointed like an angle. The soil is damped and thus there is an evergreen forest. Every soft types of the trees are found here in the among them too. That is golden Michelia, pine tree, Himalayan cedar, chestnut, chir pine, silk curtain trees, needlewood, bed buns, alder, bamboo, rhododendron, beech, etc. are mostly found here. So next one is the alpine forest. The vegetation found in this hilly region and lower Himalayan regions are altitude of 3,351 meter to 5,000 meter, whereas there is a low temperature and less rainfalls, is called alpine forest. Since the climate is cold and dry at this height, The tall, big and hard type of the trees cannot grow well here. Among the alpine vegetation, smaller trees like rhododendron, reed and small bushes like trees are found up to the altitude of 3600 meters and above that large grasslands are found. In the upper part of the multicolored bukit flower and herbs are found. The next one is tundra vegetation. Since the snowfall occurs at the altitude of about 5000 meters, plants cannot grow here. Only the algae and fungi grow in the slope of the snow cannot stop. The algae and fungi that grow here where other plants cannot grow are called tundra vegetation and cold desert vegetation. So this is also called cold desert vegetation. So thank you. So we'll meet you in the next class.